feels colder than that out. Well, it's 9 degrees. 49 Fahrenheit. The leaves and bushes are all starting to bud. That's what's killing me is the pollen. Look at these little chipmunks. Now they got 3 holes in my new steps. I think I'm gonna bury a ABS pipe in there and then cement it in. So they got 1 hole in or out. I'm living under this floor and it's warm. Okay, so I'm going to just fire this bike up quickly, make sure it runs all right. You turn the fuel on, reserve. And I'm sure it's gonna run a little leaner. I'm not gonna do any jetting to it now until I take it for a good test drive, because I knew there was something wrong. It was just running too rich. I could smell fuel, and that float was up too high. And so the gas level was just soaking in that black gasket. That's why that fuel was going dark. I'd never seen that before, but it's probably common on those bikes, but we figured it out. Okay, let me fire this thing up. Gotta open up the garage door. I think I'll leave it on here because I'm gonna do the brakes soon. Okay. Give it a little choke, got the fuel on. Give it a pump. If neutral light's not always working. No, it's in here. On this metal frame here, so it's rattling like hell. Couldn't see where the next idle screw was. Oh, fuck, that starter was gonna come apart too. Killing me. Got the battery charger on it. Should fire right up. We'll be right back. warm up before I can dial that curve in. Started this up, there was no lifter noise at all. Now they're starting to tick. When I first started up, no lifter noise at all, dead quiet. And as it's warming up and the oil's warming up, I'm getting more lifter noise. So I know it's not oil restriction or anything like that. It's lifters, it's those S&S lifters. But I'm noticing the rear intake lifter is a little noisier than the other ones. You can hear a lot more louder tap when you use a stethoscope there. So that might be a weaker lifter in there. I'm gonna replace those. Don't like it, but it's good enough for right now. I could check resetting of them and maybe take out a little bit more free play on them. Like, it's supposed to be, I've got it set so it's in the middle of the road in the lifter. I may set it so it's a little bit more solid down near the bottom, if that helps. But she runs good. The starter motor needs some work, probably the starter clutch, but when the battery's dead, like when the battery is weak like that, you don't get a good engagement. But I'll be checking the starter solenoid and the starter clutch and all that, but not too worried about that right now. Okay, when she runs good, strong, it's got a nice sound. There's no popping, no snapping, like no air leaks. Yeah, all of that part mechanically sounds good, looks good. Okay, that's it for now.